We're here for our series on working AI, and I'm joined today by Megha. Megha, can you go ahead and introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Megha. I'm a software engineer at Glean, and I work on Glean's Work AI platform.
Today we're talking about the Glean Assistant and how we improve the quality of LLMs here at Glean. So to start us off, you know, Glean takes a model-agnostic approach where users can bring their own models, whether they're using OpenAI GPT, Google Gemini, Anthropic Claude, and more. How does the Glean Assistant actually work with these LLMs?
For the kind of complex queries that users ask Glean, we find that we need to use frontier models like GPT-4o, Gemini 1.5 Pro, and Claude 3.5 Sonnet. Glean Assistant is based on a RAG architecture, which stands for Retrieval Augmented Generation. We integrate the company knowledge into the LLMs in a way that makes sure that there's a strict permission check on what data is going to the LLM.
Core to Glean's Work AI platform is search. How do the optimization strategies differ between workplace search and assistant?
Search is a well-established problem. People have been solving it for quite some time, and because of that, there are lots of mature algorithms that exist. Assistants are a relatively new phenomena. In search, the user is issuing a query, and they're just looking at a list of results. You get a lot of signals from the interaction that the user makes with the system. Does the user click on a result? What was the position of the result that they clicked on? Did they spend any time on the page after clicking? Compared to that, an assistant, you don't get that much interaction from the user. Assistant just has a single shot in providing a good response. So there's nothing to track. Did they click on something or did they visit a page and how long did they spend on it? So that's why like optimizing assistant is a lot more challenging than optimizing search. As to the strategies, there are a lot of different avenues that are available to assistants. So there's some that we are exploring at Glean. First one is query planning. Usually the query that people ask assistant is a natural language question. And so assistant can really spend some time, some thinking to break it down into a series of steps and like figure out like what is the right tools or like what's the right query to issue in order to solve each of these steps. And none of this is like a single shot. After issuing those queries, like the retrieval engine might return certain documents and the LLM might read it and decide that it needs to reformulate the query and like do this in kind of an agentic loop. The other avenue for optimization is context selection. We all know that the context window of these LLMs have been increasing over time, but they're still limited to the amount of data that is there in a company. So it's really important to pick what are you sending to the LLM, because there is obviously additional cost and latency if you send a lot of data to the LLMs.
For LLM, there are three well-established optimization strategies. You have RAG, which we've talked about, prompting, which is a little bit about this query planning, and also fine tuning. And usually companies will use a combination of all three together to get the best result. How does Glean kind of think about using these different optimization strategies together?
Prompting actually forms the instructions that you send to the LLMs. And so at Glean, we think about how to create the best prompt. And there are lots of well-known guides, like you want to write your instructions to be clear, you want to break down complex tasks into simpler subtasks that's easy for an LLM to follow. And you also want to give these models some time to think. In addition to that, at Glean, we've built this prompt library that lets users create their own prompts and then share it with other people at the company. So that when you find something that really works for your custom workflow, you can use it multiple times. Under the hood, Glean also does a lot of work to make sure that these complex prompts that our users want to write like works in the most effective manner. Fine-tuning involves showing to the LLM what does like a good thing look like. We fine-tune our embedding models to understand the company-specific data so that it becomes good at identifying the unique language in a company. These fine-tuned models do much better than using any off-the-shelf embedding model. We've done fine-tuning at search layer than doing at the generation layer. We find that doing it in the generation layer, the LLMs can actually retain some of this information during training, and then they can leak information to users who don't have permission to see them. And so by using RAG, we integrate this information to LLMs, but in a very privacy-preserving manner.
Retrieval and generation play a very large role in the overall assistant performance. How do we evaluate the assistant?
Evaluation is very important for us at Glean. And since our system is based on this RAG architecture, when we think about evaluation, we evaluate both of these components independently. So at the retrieval side, we're trying to evaluate, did we find the most relevant document for this user's question? At generation side, we're trying to answer, like, did the model find the most relevant information from this document? And did it provide like a complete response to the user? And there are two main dimensions that evaluate the generation of these models. So first is completeness. Is it answering the user's query in a complete manner? And groundedness, is the response that it's generating, is that grounded in the context that it was shared to it? Because it's very important for us to not only generate complete responses, but they should be grounded in the company's knowledge. We use an LLM to kind of automate the evaluation. And using LLMs to evaluate the performance of other LLM is actually the direction in which this industry is headed. Because manually reviewing responses is just very time consuming, it's expensive, and it does not scale. There is a misconception that human grading is always like perfect, or they're always aligned on the grading. We actually did this experiment where we asked our team members to grade certain responses from the assistant, and we found that they only aligned on like 79%. And compared to that, like, our AI evaluator system already aligns with humans on 74%. And the way we use this AI evaluator system is that whenever a new model gets launched, we evaluate it internally before we make the decision whether or not to support it for our customers. And also for any internal changes that we are making, we evaluate that using our system so that we make sure that we only ship changes that are actually overall doing better for the users.
What do you see as the future of assistants at work?
Today, I think people are mostly using assistants to summarize and create content. An example of this is that there's a leading global telecom company, which is a customer, and they have their support agents use Glean Assistant to help them resolve customer issues. Since Assistant can pull in information from all these different documents, it can actually help them create customized responses. In the future, we believe that these systems are going to behave a lot more autonomously. They're going to be able to do a lot of these end-to-end execution. So for any complex tasks, they'll be able to figure out like what are the things that they need to do, and then they can go ahead and integrate with the systems and do that. It could be an end-to-end execution where it not just resolves a support ticket, but it also files a bug report or a Jira ticket for a feature request. It could also loop in the account team if a user is at risk of churn. At Glean, we believe that these assistants are just the starting point of this journey of being able to get to that full agentic capabilities. When we're designing the assistants today to provide accurate and correct responses to the users, we're also thinking about a future when these systems can route and execute things in this end-to-end manner.
Thank you so much, Megha. I appreciate you sharing more about the assistant and how we think about ensuring AI quality here at Glean.
Thanks for having me.